Hello everyone, this is Dr. Khalid Imran. I welcome you to the fifth lecture series on machine tools of module 5 of the subject Elements of Mechanical Engineering. So in the previous session, we had discussed about milling machines. I had discussed about what is a milling machine. It's a power operated machine tool wherein the job is moved against the revolving serrated cutter. And we had discussed different types of operations and the principle of milling. So we know that there are two principles of milling. One is known as conventional milling, one is climb milling. If the workpiece is fed against the milling cutter, then it is known as conventional milling. And if the workpiece is fed in the direction of the rotation of the milling cutter, it is known as climb milling. And then we had seen different types of milling machines. One is your planar horizontal milling machine, then we have vertical milling machine, universal milling machine, special type milling machine, profile cutting milling machine. So there are a variety of milling machines, out of which, as far as your syllabus was concerned, we have only two. One is your horizontal milling machine and one is vertical milling machine. I had explained the entire functionality of it, how it works, the working principle of horizontal milling machine. In fact, you had witnessed a video also. Then we had seen the working of vertical milling machine. You had also seen the video of vertical milling machine. Then we had seen what are the differences between vertical and horizontal milling machine. Then we started with milling processes. We have discussed what is plane milling, what is end milling, slot milling. Yeah, three milling processes have been discussed so far. We are left out with angular milling, form milling, straddle milling and gang milling. So let us, this is about plane milling. We know that if the cutter axis is parallel to the workpiece and if the cutter is mounted in the arbor and when the workpiece is rotated in the direction or against the direction of the milling cutter, that is known as slab milling. This is the amount of material removed. Then this was a video which you had witnessed. Then this is end milling. End milling operation is basically carried out in a vertical milling machine. So by the help of end milling, many operations like grooving operation, then keyway cutting operation, making a recess in the workpiece. So many operations can be performed, pocketing operations can be performed using end milling cutter. So like, you know, this is a very versatile type of multi-point cutting tool. Then we had discussed slot milling operation, and this is known as the slot drill. So whenever it is not practically possible for end milling operation to proceed with, then we go for slot milling operation. So whenever the spaces are very tight so that the end mill cannot be inserted, those places we adopt slot milling operation. Even when the thickness of the groove desired is very, very small, then slot milling is the most preferred one compared to end milling operation. Indeed, you had also seen the video of this. Next is your angular milling operation. So angular milling operation is once again carried out in a horizontal milling machine. You can see that this is the arbor, and whenever a cutting tool like this is an angular milling cutter, this angular milling cutter is placed or keyed with the arbor on a horizontal milling machine. So we can see here that the axis of the arbor, or I can say the axis of this milling cutter, is parallel to the workpiece. In that case, this operation is basically carried out on a horizontal milling machine. Right? So you have the cutter, you have the arbor, you have the workpiece. So angular milling machine can be of different profiles rather. Even we can cut, you know, dovetail groove. There are different types of grooves or keyways. It can be a rectangular keyway, it can be a square keyway, it can be a dovetail keyway. So dovetail keyways, if we recall in a lathe, the cross lathe sits on the saddle. And the cross light moves in a transverse direction, means it moves in a direction perpendicular to the lathe axis. How exactly it moves? Because of the dovetail guideways provided just beneath the cross light. So when the cross light is moved, that particular table or the block moves over the saddle by the help of the cross, by the help of the dovetail guideways. So that is like, dovetail guideways can be easily machined or made by the help of your angular milling cutter. Besides dovetail cutting, by using angular milling, we can also perform chamfering operation. Then side milling operation can also be performed using your angular milling cutters. So this is a very versatile type of multi-point cutting tool by the help of which the dovetail grooves can be conveniently manufactured or made. So if you watch this particular video, you can witness how exactly the angular milling takes place. From the close-up, you can see this is the milling cutter. This is the angular milling cutter. You can see it's bevel of 45 degrees. It has an angle of 45 degrees, which is used to cut the material at an angle. You can see here, this is the raw material being cut, machined. And this is a horizontal milling machine. You can see the arbor. This is the arbor. This is the coolant, the white fluid which is coming out of the fluid is the coolant. This coolant helps in dissipating the heat. The heat generated between the cutting tool and the workpiece is enormous. So it has to be dissipated. It is dissipated by applying the cutting fluids or basically the coolant. So this is all about the angular milling. I hope all of you have understood what exactly is angular milling operation. Next comes your form milling operation. So there are various, we know that there are different types of multi-point cutting tools which can be accommodated either in the horizontal milling machine or in the vertical milling machine. Like you have the end mill, you have the side mill in case of a vertical milling machine. In case of a horizontal milling machine, we do have slab milling or a plane milling cutter. Then just now we saw a slot milling cutter. Then we have the angular milling. The next type of milling is form milling, wherein the shape, dimension, geometry of the form milling cutter is unique. It all depends upon the type of profile desired. So if the profile in the workpiece is desired in this fashion, in this manner, wherein you get a concave type of cavity here, two flat surfaces. So if at all you want to perform various operations simultaneously, we can have one single form milling cutter. Suppose you want a curvilinear geometry here like this in the workpiece. In that case, we try to manufacture or make a form milling cutter. This is a user-defined milling cutter. So usually form milling cutters are special purpose cutters, or you can say these can be fabricated or made based upon the design requirements, based upon what type of profile one wants to generate in the workpiece. So some of the form milling cutters are available in the market, wherein we need, those are the common type of forms which are desirable. But there are some forms or geometries which are user defined. So these are, customer specific, customized type of milling cutters are manufactured. So they are ordered to a company which makes these tools. And the company or the manufacturer of the cutting tools, he supplies to the vendor, to the person who wants to manufacture a particular groove of that particular shape and size. In that case, they go for form milling cutters. Thereby, when a form milling cutter is fixed on the arbor of a horizontal milling machine, and when the work is fed against the rotating form milling cutter, then what happens? We get a shape here, we get a geometry or a recess or a cutout or a keyway, I can say, which will resemble the exact shape of the form milling cutter. So by, you can see this, we can watch the video and you will get a very clear idea about form milling operation. Yeah, this is an animated video. Yeah, this is a form milling cutter, a special unique type of milling cutter which will not be available in the market. This has to be customized basically. It has to be customized so that the manufacturer, he orders for this, and when he uses this type of form milling cutter, you can see the geometry design of this milling cutter and the groove which is obtained here. You can see the recess, the amount of material cut resembles the shape, size and geometry of this form milling cutter. So in one go, by accommodating this milling cutter on the arbor in a horizontal milling machine, one can achieve user defined grooves or recesses or keyways of this fashion or any other pattern. So that is the beauty of this operation. You can see the resemblance here. Yes, so that is the amount of material cut. I hope all of you have understood what exactly is form milling operation. The next type of operation is a straddle milling operation. Straddle milling operation is very much prevalent, wherein two workpiece surfaces are to be side milled simultaneously, or I can say are to be machined simultaneously. Now this is your the cutting tool or a multi-point cutting tool. This is one more cutter, one more cutter here. Two cutters are separated by spacers. Spacers are similar to washers. So we have different thicknesses of spacers. Those spacers are put in between two cutters. This is cutter number one, cutter number two. When spacers are accommodated or filled between these two milling cutters, these two are separated by a particular width. So the desired width is obtained by accommodating the spacers of the same width. For example, I want some 15 millimeters between these two cutters as the spacer. So we put a 15 millimeter spacer in between these two milling cutters. One example of this type of operation is your machining surfaces. You can machine two surfaces of hexagonal headed bolt. So we know that there will be six lateral surfaces of a hexagonal headed bolt. You'll be having flat surfaces. So if at all two faces are to be machined simultaneously, then the workpiece is clamped in the vise in the work holding device, and these two cutters are mounted on the arbor of a horizontal milling machine separated by the spacers. The spacer width depends upon the width between the two work surfaces which are to be machined here. So when the workpiece is fed against these rotating cutters together, either in the direction of the rotation or against the direction of the rotation, then the machining operation takes place. So the unwanted material, you can see this is the material which is there earlier. This material is removed. The unwanted material is removed on both the surfaces simultaneously, parallelly it is done. So two operations carrying out at one particular time is known as straddle milling operation. And this is performed basically on a horizontal milling machine. So if you witness the next video, you can clearly understand what is straddle milling. Yeah, even this is an animated video. Just watch this, you can see here. This is the unwanted material to be removed on both the sides so that I get fresh two surfaces. This are the two cutters mounted on the arbor, separated by the spacers. These are the spacers here, you can see in between. So we are getting two new surfaces, two vertical surfaces simultaneously. So by the help of straddle milling, two surfaces can be simultaneously machined. I hope you have understood what is straddle milling. The next and the last operation in your milling machine is gang milling operation. So gang milling operation is one such operation wherein we want to perform multiple type of grooves we need to make on the workpiece. So we have, you can see this can be the guide way, like these are the guide way of a lathe. It's a V guide way, you can see here. This is once again a groove here. This is a flat surface. How many operations we are performing on a workpiece at one time? This is the arbor on which all the tools are mounted here together. So gang milling operation, either these types of all these cutters can be locked together by some mechanism, or we can have a gang milling cutter which is once again customized in this particular geometry, dimension and design. So that you can see a slab milling cutter here, once again a slab milling cutter, then this is a slot milling cutter or a slot drill, then once again we have an angular milling cutter. There are so many things here. You can see double angular milling cutter, then we have a plane or a slab milling cutter. This cutter can be a slot milling cutter or a slot drill. So 1 and 2 are this and this are plane milling cutters. One is slot milling cutter and one is double angular milling cutter. When all these types of cutters are, you know, integrated as one single cutting tool, as one single multi-point cutting tool, and mounted securely on the arbor of a horizontal milling machine, and the work is fed either in the direction of the rotation of the milling cutter or against the direction of the rotation of the milling cutter, then what do we get? We get different profiles in the workpiece. So we have a rectangular recess or a square recess. We have once again a V type of guideways. We have obtained two flat surfaces simultaneously, parallelly. We are getting all these operations, right? So thereby, we are, what we can infer from this? We can infer that the amount of time taken is lesser. Instead of carrying out one operation at a time, if all the milling cutters are combined together, and if they are, you know, if the workpiece is machined using the combination of cutters, then the amount of time taken by gang milling operation is quite lesser. But it all depends upon the application, it all depends upon the requirement. If at all the manufacturer wants all the operations to be in one single go, in one single step, then they can go for gang milling operation. But if he's particular about one particular operation at a time, he just wants, you know, slab milling in one go, next he wants the slot milling, it all depends upon the requirement, then gang milling is the most desirable type of operation, wherein we can get multiple recesses of different shapes, geometries at a time, simultaneously, parallelly. So probably I have a video here. You can just watch this video to understand the gang milling operation. Yeah, you can see there are four cutters here. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this is the workpiece. It's a huge gang milling machine. Gang is basically combination of cutting tools, multi-point cutting tools. So we have four multi-point cutting tools here, like we have four slab milling cutters. And using these four slab milling cutters, the entire work is, you know, machined parallelly, four different surfaces. This is one example of it. You can see here the workpiece is being, you know, machined for here, 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 and here. So at four different places, the workpiece is being machined simultaneously, parallelly. And that is the beauty of this gang milling operation. This is the workpiece presented. And these are the cutters. There are two arbors here. You can see arbor 1, arbor 2. In the same horizontal milling machine. So this is a special type of milling machine. See, besides conventional machine tools, there are special purpose machine tools. Special purpose machines, we call them as SPMs. Using those SPMs, we can perform special operations which consumes less amount of time. Especially manufacturing industries who are manufacturing products in mass, we say mass producing industries, those industries can opt for this. I hope gang milling operation is quite clear to you now. What is gang milling operation when compared to straddle milling? Straddle milling is similar to it, but here there are four surfaces which are being machined parallelly. Whereas in case of straddle milling, there were only two surfaces. So that's all about your gang milling operation. Yes, so this concludes your machine tools part in your fifth module, that is machine tools and advanced manufacturing systems. Now we'll be starting with advanced manufacturing systems. But before starting with the advanced manufacturing systems, when we speak about advanced manufacturing systems, it's all about, you know, advanced machine tools. Like you have your numerically controlled machines, NC machines. Then we have computer numerically controlled machines. Then we have automated guided vehicles. Then we have automated storage and retrieval systems. There are many things which comes under automated systems. So this advanced manufacturing systems is part of automation. So if you see this particular thing, advanced manufacturing system is nothing but your automation. Why? Because in advanced manufacturing system, we will be dealing with machine tools, advanced machine tools, not your conventional machine tools like lathe, drilling machine or milling machine. We deal with machines such as computer numerically controlled machines. In short, we call them as CNC machines. Then we have, you know, DNC machines, direct numerically controlled machines. So we will be dealing only with CNC machines here. That too, what exactly is a CNC lathe? We can give an analogy of lathe with respect to computer numerically controlled machines. So when we speak of CNC, it can be a CNC lathe, it can be a CNC drilling machine, it can be a CNC milling machine. We call them as turning centers, drilling centers, milling centers, and there can be combination of this. There can be turn drill center, there can be turn drill mill center, means all three machine tools, turning machine, drilling machine, as well as milling machine put together. It will be a huge machine. It will be a very huge machine where a variety of operations can be performed without any human intervention. That is the beauty of automation. So this advanced manufacturing systems not only deals with the advanced machine tools like CNC and DNC, we will also be seeing here what exactly is a robot, what is a robotic, what is a robotic system, different types of robotic configurations and all. But before dealing with robotics, let us, you know, throw some light on automation. Why? Because when we speak about advanced manufacturing systems, that is machine tools, what machine tools? Not your conventional one, but your advanced machine tools like CNC machine, you need to understand what is automation. Why? Because today it is an era of automation. Without automation, nobody can survive. See, automation does not mean only product which is automated. Like, you know, a product which is manufactured in a company. A company need not only be automated. Today, even the service industry, be it your education sector, or be it your telecommunication sector, be it your hospitals, which are service sector, everything is automated. Today, by click of a button, we order food. For example, you have Zomato and all, we order and we get the food within no time. So, like, you know, everything, the service is automated here. But when we speak about the manufacturing industries, most of the manufacturing industries are automated industries. See, we cannot rely upon old systems wherein people used to manufacture mechanical components or mechanical parts using your chisel, hammer, files and all. Now it is an era of precision and accuracy, wherein every vendor, every customer, every consumer as such, they want parts to be of utmost precision and accuracy. Suppose you want to purchase a washing machine, then what do we expect? We expect it has to be of best quality. So everyone is running behind quality. There is no definition for quality. Why? Because quality is always improving. It is a process of improvement basically. We try to improve a product, we try to improve a component or a product or an assembly or a service. That is all about your quality. So when we speak about automation, the main objective of automation is to reach higher quality, better quality. So gone are those days when they used to use hand tools, as I told you, chisels, hammers and all. We have machine tools. We discussed in the previous session, even in this session, you saw what is a milling machine and all. These are conventional machine tools. But in most of the big manufacturing industries, which are, you know, multinational companies, transnational companies, huge MNCs, those companies wherein manufacturing is their core job, they do not rely upon your conventional machine tools like your lathe and milling machine. They always, you know, opt for your high advanced manufacturing tools, machines like your CNC machines, milling centers, turning centers and all. And this turning centers, milling centers, I can say the CNC machines are part of automation. And even robotics is part of automation. Then we have automated guided vehicles. Even that is the part of automation. So automation is holistic. It holds a holistic view. See, the concept of automation has been evolved from mechanization. And what do you mean by mechanization? Mechanization is a process of having mechanical movements without any human intervention, or I can say with least human intervention. So if at all you want to produce a circular object on a simple lathe, then human being is involved there. So human being, the operator, he makes a particular part on a conventional lathe, like a central lathe or an engine lathe, even on a turret or a capstan, which are automatic lathes. But when we speak about automation, automation comprises of high-end machine tools like a CNC machine, a milling center. It also comprises of robots operating into the work cell. Then we do have automated guided vehicles. There will be automated storage and retrieval systems, ASRS. There will be programmable logic circuits or logic controllers, PLCs, what we say. So automation system is combination of all these things, your machine tools, your robotics, your AGVs, your ASRS, so on and so forth. So as far as definition of automation is concerned, though this part is not there in your syllabus, automation, I just want to throw some light on what is automation. Why? Because before understanding the part of automation, which are advanced machine tools like CNC, you need to know what is automation. Automation means set of technologies of carrying out a process to manufacture a product or assembly, whatever, without human assistance or with least human assistance, and achieves performance superior to manual operation. Of course, when a human being does perform some operation on a machine tool like lathe or a drilling machine, which is a conventional one, obviously on account of fatigue, on account of exhaustion, the accuracy and precision of operation will come down drastically. We cannot imagine a human being operating on a machine tool for 5 or 6 hours continuously, not even 2 hours. He has to take breaks. And whenever breaks are taken, the lead times increases, the idle time increases. Thereby, the efficiency also comes down when a human being is continuously operating a machine. So that being the reason, because of this big lacuna, this big limitation, everyone wants automation, wherein human beings are replaced basically by machines for higher accuracy, for more repeatability. Any human being, when he does the same job from morning to evening, he gets exhausted. He gets exhausted and the efficiency will drop down. In order to overcome this limitation, every manufacturing company, especially the big ones, the MNCs, the transnationals, those companies, they want automation. So, automation can be of three types. Basically, this is very fundamental thing about automation. We say as fixed automation or hard automation. There is programmable automation or soft automation, and there is flexible automation. Fixed automation is an automation, is a process in which wherein a particular component or a particular product is manufactured in mass, like especially mass producing industry, they go for fixed automation. It is basically very much hardwired. Some special purpose machines are used for fixed automation. Assume that a company is only manufacturing one type of bolts. So from they have two shifts or three shifts. In every shift, they're manufacturing the same. So the volume of production is very, very high here, but the variety of production is very, very less. On the other hand, when we speak about programmable automation, then here we can have a variety of products. Assume that a company which is manufacturing hardware products like you have hinges, you have knobs, you have handles, hardware items. So every shift will produce a different component. Thereby, some amount of setup time has to be given for the machine. For example, one shift, assume that there are CNC machines, advanced machines, which produce knobs, circular knobs, for one shift, for 8 hours. The next shift, they will change. Like the CNC machines can manufacture handles. The only thing is, it has to be reprogrammed. So we say programmable automation. It is known as soft automation. The advantage of soft automation is what? It consumes, it gives more flexibility. You have a variety, product variety is very eminent here. Whereas in fixed automation, the variety is lesser. Then we have flexible automation. Flexible automation is basically combination of fixed and programmable automations. All the limitations, the limitation of fixed automation is what? The variety is not available. Coming to programmable automation, here it takes a bit longer time to set up a mission. Though we get variety, but the time consumed to set up the mission for the next type of job is a bit longer. So that is one limitation. So both the limitations are overcome in flexible automation. Here there is no human intervention at all. We can have a variety of jobs with least setup times. That is known as flexible automation. Then there are, you know, three important components of any automation system. One is your power source. The power source can be a battery power source. It can be mains AC supply. Then we have the program of instructions. The program of instructions are nothing but the commands, the algorithm which is written by the programmer. So in this entire programmer, all the machine operations are coded. See, we encode all this either in form of punch tapes. Nowadays, we have different devices. We have softwares. You can write your program. So once the program of instruction is complete, then the program of instruction is fed to the control system. The control system recognizes the commands which are given in the program of instructions, and it, you know, sends the signal to the process. What is the process? The last term here. The process is nothing but the machine tool, I can say. It can be a machine tool, it can be a robot, it can be an automated guided vehicle, it can be automated storage and retrieval system, anything. That is the process here. So once again, control system can be closed loop and it can be open loop. So closed loop is more costlier and open loop is a bit economical. So that we'll discuss later. This is all about your advanced manufacturing systems. Introduction of advanced manufacturing systems, which deals with automation. So based upon your automation, then we have, you know, the first system known as your computer numerically control system, which is part of your automation system. As I told you, your machine tools can be what? Computer numerically controlled. A lathe can be computer numerically controlled. A drilling machine can be numerically controlled. And in fact, a milling machine can also be it can be numerically controlled. So in general, I can say a CNC machine can be a turning machine, it can be a milling machine, it can be a drilling machine, it can be combination of all this. It can be combination of lathe and drilling. So we say turn drill center. So a computer numerically controlled, or CNC in short, is an advanced form of ENC system. Now, what is this numerically controlled system? Numerically controlled system was evolved in 1940s, wherein the program of instructions were encoded on a paper punched tape, or on a tape, or just on a piece of paper. And it was fed to the machine, wherein automatically the operations were performed. That was your numerically controlled system. And it was totally hardwired. Whereas a CNC is what? An advanced version of numerically controlled machine. So it says that CNC is an advanced form of numerically controlled system, where the machine control unit is dedicated microcomputer instead of hardwire controller as in conventional NC. So first is your conventional machines, like your engine lathe or speed lathe or turret or whatever. Then after that, we have your NC machines, numerically controlled machines, wherein the information in form of codes is what? It is encoded on punched tapes. That was the, you know, approach. Later on, the NC machines improved. Why? Because of the huge technological advancements in computer technology. Since, you know, computers were more intelligent, when computers are integrated with machines, then the name is what? Computer numerically controlled machines. So CNC technology has powered the entire machine tool industry. So most of the automotive parts, the aerospace parts, which are very critical rather, most of the automotive parts are very critical parts. Nobody can take the risk of manufacturing a part to lesser accuracy or lesser precision by adopting only conventional machines. So most of the conglomerates, most of the multinational companies, for example, you have automotive giants, like you have your Maruti, then we have the Volkswagen, right? We have Ford. All these companies, they will not rely upon your conventional machine tools like simple lathe and all. They adopt, CNC lathe, a CNC drilling machine, advanced machines. So most of the machine tool industry today as of now, in the present scenario, are all powered by CNC technology. And it is used in majority of the tools, like as I told you, machining centers, turning centers, we say CNC grinders, CNC lathes, or these things are there. So today's CNC controller has the, what exactly are the features of a CNC controller or the CNC control unit? So the speed of operation, but this is the biggest advantage. The operation speed is very, very high. All the positional tolerances can be achieved, and we can detect what is the position of the tool and the workpiece. Any deviation at the tool work interface can be detected and corrected. And we have large memory, you have RAM, ROM, you have bus architectures, and there are very good servos. We have servo motors, stepper motors. So there are many good features. One of the best features are what? The speed of operation is very, very high. Large memory is available so that, you know, n number of instructions can be stored into it. And we have bus architectures and improved servers. So this is all about your computer numerically controlled machines. And we do have the entire functionality or description of the CNC machine. What are the components of CNC machine? Description of all these components, then what do you understand by part programming? All these things we'll be doing in the succeeding sessions in next class. So today I think we'll stop here. So next class we'll be studying what exactly are the components of computer numerically controlled machines, the fundamental components. So this can be this machine tool, what you see, it can be a lathe, this can be a drilling machine, or it can be a milling machine. And the entire system is an automated system. So in the next succeeding class, in the next class, we will discuss components of CNC. Then part is, what is part programming? All these are components. Then the operations carried out on a CNC machine. So these things we'll discuss in detail in the upcoming class. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching this video.